My faith is healing his name, I believe. enter. See your kingdom come. My Redeemer lives. My Redeemer lives. My Redeemer lives. My Redeemer lives.
Good morning. Welcome to Harbourview. This is Sunday, September the 27th, and we are beginning another approach to church online, and this is an opportunity for us as a church to be able to broadcast to all who want to attend via the online, and also for those who want to watch online together in different locations. And so welcome to everybody. It's great to have you. I'm Paul Bergman. I'm the pastor of Harbourview Church, and it's so good to be here together. Let me start with a word from Psalm 18, and I believe it's very appropriate for the days that we find ourselves in, where there's a lot of concern and fear, and even now there's a sirens going off behind us as there's concern on the roads, and we all have our own concerns and anxieties and fears. And Psalm 18 starts this way: I love you, Lord, for you are my strength. That's the place to pause, realign priorities and understanding of God the Creator. The Lord is my rock, he says, my fortress, my deliverer. My God is my rock in whom I take refuge. There's no doubt in David's mind where he stands to find his confidence. He says he's my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. I call to the Lord who's worthy of praise, and I'm saved from my enemies. And so this morning, may you find a place of refuge in the Lord, your strength, and your relationship with him. And it may be broad all across the board for people in their relationship with God. We're all moving towards that maturity, and I challenge you this morning just to pause and to be in that place where God can meet you, communicate you to you, because he's always speaking, and so you can be in that place with an increased sense of his pleasure and also of his security in these days. Let me pray for you, and then we're going to go into our first song and a call to worship. And so, Jesus, I pray for our church. I pray for our community and our families, and I give you thanks for the provision that you give to us in these days. You are good. You are our strength, O Lord, and we call out to you in these days, and we thank you and praise you first and foremost, for you are our salvation. And we work out that salvation now, Lord, as we prepare our hearts, as we live our days, and we have our trajectory that you've placed us upon, and may we find ourselves faithful in these days, Lord, knowing that you are more than faithful and able to meet us where we're at. And so, Father, would you come alongside of us this morning as we hear from your word and are challenged in this vein. And thank you that you go before us. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Tender.
Good to be together and worshiping. In just a few moments, I want to share a message with you from a man named Jason King, who's a pastor in the Colorado Denver area. Back in April, he had a word that he believed came from the Lord, and he was communicating, talking to an organization called YWAM. YWAM means Youth with a Mission. It's a global mission movement, and you're going to hear the word YWAM quite a bit. And I would just invite you to, as we're listening to this, to appropriate this to yourself and to our local church context as well. For it is a word, and he mentions that for all organizations and churches, Christian organizations. He references this time during the pandemic, of course, and how God has really shaken up the foundations, as we mentioned earlier, of what we find our country's built upon, and everything is being shaken. And we need to stand firm on some principles and what God is communicating and talking to us. And in this series that we have through Harbourview called Whisper, listening to the voice of God, what is he saying to us? What's he saying to the church in these days? And having an ear to hear what Jesus wants to say to the church. This is a word for us. This is a word for us as a church. And so I don't want you to take this personally. I want you to take this to heart. Grab a pen and paper if you can. Turn to Luke chapter 15 and listen again as Jason pulls out some principles for us to apply directly to our lives as things are being shaken up and there's massive disruption in our lives. Enjoy, my friends.
And let's listen to what the Lord is saying. Jason King, thanks for taking the time to be with us, bro. Just share from your heart. Don't hold back, however the Lord is leading you.
Yeah, all right. Thank you, Peter. And really, it's an honor to be with all of you today. I so appreciate what God's called you to do uniquely in the kingdom of God. But I do really sense I have a word for YWAM. As I was sharing, as Peter was saying, and while I was speaking, as all of us know, the Lord kind of interrupts our own thoughts. And the Lord, I really feel like the Lord said, this is a global word for YWAM. And so I just want to share with you my heart. I think it's the purposes of God in these seasons to do something fresh and new. And I think so many times we pray against situations like this. And as we should, whatever is the strategy of the enemy, whatever that is, we pray against it. But also, I really felt like the Lord wanted us to get a different perspective on the situation we're going through and you're going through as a mission, as an organization. And I want to propose some things today that I believe God wants us, would like you to consider, is the usefulness of famine and how God wants to use it, not only for you as an individual in your own ministry, your own unique individual calling, but as an organization of YWAM. And a couple things I just want to lay out before I get into some of these specific things I feel like God has spoken to you. A couple things. One, this is not a season to survive, which all of us, all of our ministries, particularly for YWAM, this is not a season to survive, to wait, and to return to normal on the other side of this. This is a season of preparation for the new future that God has for you. There is a new future on the other side of this. I believe in the kingdom of God, globally, all ministry, all churches, but particularly for YWAM. And so I really believe this, that if you are the same on the other side of this, then you have missed the opportunity and the benefits and the usefulness of a of this disruption in life. And so I just want to give you a couple things, and I'll give you the points here that I believe God has spoken. But I want us just to open our hearts for a second and think about how God has used disruptions in life to position people for something significant. And so God used famine. And right now, what a famine is, it's a disruption of the normal. It's a disruption of where we would normally, our normal patterns, our normal channels of provision, our normal channels of even interaction with one another. Famine disrupts everything. And that's exactly where we are, not just as a nation or North America, but as the world. There has been a disruption of the normal. And so God used a disruption, it was famine, to position Joseph as the second in command in Egypt. Also, through that disruption and through him, his positioning, God used it to restore his relationship with his family. So there's restoration in the midst of famine. And because of his position of being promoted to second in command, because how God had showed him through the dream what was coming, he was able to provide. Joseph was able to provide for the 12 tribes of Israel. In the book of Ruth, God used famine to move Naomi and Ruth to Bethlehem, in which Ruth, of course, we know, met Boaz. Boaz had Obed. Obed had Jesse. Jesse had David. Through the line of David became Jesus. But I want us to pull some things out of the prodigal son, the parable of the prodigal son. And I really believe that God wants to speak to you. And I also want to clarify something. I don't feel in any way that God is saying that YWAM is a prodigal, but I do feel that God wants to point out some principles from this parable to bring clarity to what God is doing and what he wants you to be aware of what God is doing. So again, remember, famine is the disruption of our normal systems. And there are some ways, though, that I believe God wants you to benefit from this disruption. And I'll just give you some of these points. And, my heart is that you would become everything God wants you to be, because I love YWAM. And so hear my heart in all of this, prophetically in what I'm saying. So what is God wanting to do in YWAM right now through this disruption? What feels like a famine, what feels like a cutoff of normal channels? Number one, I believe God wants to use this disruption to bring humility. Now, these points are taken from the story of the prodigal son. I believe God has shown me as I was reading this. So the prodigal son, what famine allowed in his life and produced in his life was humility. It says he went out and he hired himself and was sent to the fields to feed the pigs. Okay, prodigal son, he's a Jew. Pigs are considered unclean. He grew up his whole life being taught pigs are unclean. And those who raised them are unclean. Those who interacted with them were unrighteous. And it's that moment of famine that brought him to a place of humility. He was humbled. He looked around and he said, God, what's going on? What am I doing in my life? And I believe God wants to use this season, this disruption, to bring humility to YWAM, to a sense of softness of the heart. Number two, what I felt like God has spoken is this. God wants to awaken your senses to the true reality of the ministry of YWAM. God wants to awaken your senses to the true reality of what's going on. So the scripture says, if you were to read this out of Luke 15, and didn't have the time to do that, but the scripture says that he, meaning the prodigal son, came to his senses. So what that means, he became fully aware of his condition and the condition around him. His senses were no longer dulled by the normal. Sometimes in ministry, the normal can dull our senses. We get into patterns that are familiar, and they can dull our senses. So this is God wanting to remove any blinders that may have been placed on you through the time, through the systems, through the normal. This is the season of disruption that God wants to heighten our senses. Also, what happens for the prodigal son, that there had been some blinders, or I guess it could be deceptions or areas of his life. Obviously, as a Jew, there were areas of his life that he had allowed the the walls to be degraded in his life. And so God, I believe, wants to remove any blinders that may have been placed on, areas and beliefs that have been shaped by the world instead of God. In the midst of serving people, as we all know, as you interact with people, sometimes you can take on their offense and their beliefs without even knowing it. And I just believe that God wants to awaken the senses to be aware of really the reality of where the ministry is. Also, there are blinders and a dullness of senses that come from comfort, that come from predictability. Blinders, actually, so many times it's the blinders that sit on us, or maybe a better word would be filters, that we filter kind of our current ministry through what was at one time in the ministry versus through what is right now. And I just think this is a season. It's a gift. I really believe this is a gift for YWAM this season. And your heart and your unity, how you all unite, it's absolutely incredible. It's a great example for a lot of other ministries. But this is a season to be aware and to be honest about really how is the ministry going. God, heighten our senses. So it's seeing and recognizing where vision has drifted, where mission has drifted. This is a season, I believe, to come to your senses and truly see things for the way they are. This is a real gift from God. It's just a moment. I think it's a shift in the kingdom, which we all are sensitive, but particularly for YWAM, it's a shift. And God wants to recognize and wants you to recognize as the leaders of YWAM what that shift is. So once he came to his senses, he then saw, and so he came to his senses. He took an evaluation and he was honest. He was humbled. He came to his senses. And then he was brought to a place of repentance. And this is what he thought. This is what, and I love this, which is really ministered to me as I was praying for you all. He thought, I want to go home. I want to go home. And then he thought, what am I going to tell my father when I go home? And as we all know the story, he says, I'm going to tell him I've sinned. I've sinned against you and I've sinned against God. And I believe this disruption of COVID-19, it's a famine of some sort, is an opportunity to deeply evaluate. Once you are humble, once you come to your senses, to deeply evaluate, Father, where do we need to repent? What areas, what things do we need to cut out? What things have drifted? And this is the beautiful journey that brought the prodigal son to his restoration. And number three, God wants to use this season to lead YWAM again in repentance. And so I just want you to understand that. So after he repented, he had become one. Well, there are a couple of things I was praying about this morning. He had lost the wonder and the awe of his father. So he'd been so busy with his life, he had lost the wonder and awe of his father. And so he needed to repent from that. Another thing, he had taken for granted the benefits of being a child of his father and the inheritance that he had. Number three, he had become independent and taken for granted his whole family. And however that pertains to you, I just felt like the Lord wanted to mention that. So in this famine for the prodigal, it forced him, after he was humbled, after he came to his senses, after he repented, it forced him to prioritize. And God has gifted YWAM, I really believe, with this incredible opportunity to prioritize. This is about vision. So in disruption and in vision, you are forced to do the most important thing. Everything else, all the frills and the fluff go away, and you're forced to prioritize. And you're forced to put resources in what matters the most. And so through this season, I believe his encouragement is to put things in their rightful place. And here's the other piece, and to remove things that have drifted, and actually that have drifted into the vision that actually God doesn't want in the vision. And so this is the season to prioritize that. It's also a season to those things that have drifted out of the vision that God wants to implement back to the mission and vision. And this is just a great gift and opportunity. And this is, I believe, the season God wants to do, because I believe this is, as Peter had mentioned, this is a year of breakthrough. in the kingdom as a whole, but particularly in this area with YWAM and the global reach that it absolutely has. And then the last thing is this, I want to share with you that I believe God is going to use this time and wants you to benefit, wants you to take advantage of this, is that God wants to bring and to use this to bring you back home. When you look at the prodigal son, all of these things, from humility to repentance to him coming to his senses to taking an evaluation to him prioritize, was to bring him all the way back home and to restoration. And I just want to share this. Home is the place of your conception. Home is the burning call of God that was spoken over YWAM, over the people of YWAM. It's the place of your belonging. It's the place that this your sweet spot. It's the place of origin. And I just really feel and believe that this is an opportunity for you all to hit the reset button on vision. Reset doesn't mean a wiping away of everything. A reset means getting everything back into alignment to what originally was, to what God has spoken and is still speaking today. And I think that's a distinction. A reset button on mission, reset button on values, a reset button on relationships. Returning home, though, as I feel like God really shared this, spoke this to me this morning, returning home also requires difficult conversations and the realigning of a family culture. And I really believe this is what God is saying. So it's all of these possibilities and benefits. And there are benefits of famine, and God wants you to benefit through this time, benefit through this disruption. But it's also, as all of you know, because you're seasoned ministers, returning home, as we see in the prodigal son, if you think about it, required difficult conversations. It required difficult decisions because it was the time to realign the family culture. And so those are just the things I just really felt that God wanted to speak to you. And I pray that it's helpful. I pray that God will use this. But so that's my heart. And thank you for letting me share what I feel like God has spoken for you guys in this season.
Thank you for joining us this morning. As Jason ended his message, the challenge to us around this whole idea of repentance, and the scripture says it's God's kindness that leads to repentance. And we need to be in this, particularly in these days, as with a practice of life, to keep short accounts with God, short accounts with one another, having those difficult discussions that we need to in our lives and relationships with others, and being quick to say, you know what, I need to repent of this. I need to say sorry for this. And to live a life like that is a great way, because you're always, you know, you're aligning yourself consistently with who God is. David knew that as well. For God, he knew his God was perfect. Taking you back to Psalm 18 again, in verse 30 says, as for God, his way is perfect. And so receive the benediction. The word of the Lord is flawless. He's a shield for all who take refuge in him. For who is God except our God? And who is the rock besides the Lord? It is God who arms me with strength, and he makes my way perfect. We sometimes feel like this is not a perfect time to be living out our lives, but God is perfect, and he knows, and his ways are perfect, and we can rest in that. And so, my friends, as you go into this week, know that God's strength is with you, that you stand firmly upon his word, and he is the rock, and he already goes before you. And he's there and waiting for us to walk into it. God bless you this week. We're going to close with a song, and may you enjoy what we are experiencing in these days, for he is calling us to greater things.
Be gracious to you. thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May his favor be upon you, and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May his presence go before you, and behind you, and beside you, all around you.